So, dear students, welcome to the series of oxidative addition reactions. And in this lecture, I will discuss about the types of reagents that favor the oxidative addition reactions. So, this is the gist of oxidative addition reaction reagents. So, I can explain one by one with the help of some examples. You can see two types of reagents in case of oxidative addition reactions. So, one reagents are non-polar reagents and others are polar reagents. So, with the help of name, you can imagine that non-polar reagent. Non-polar reagents may be H2 type molecule, may be O2 type molecule, maybe the molecule having CH bond, maybe the molecule having CC bond. So they are non-polar reagents. And what are polar reagents? Polar reagents which have polar bonds, they may be alkyl halides, they may be aryl halides, they may be acids. So they are polar reagents. So these are the requirements of non-polar reagents. So the non-polar reagent, generally they require an unsaturated metal center. Now in case of inorganic molecules, unsaturation means less number of electrons. So their electrons are not 18. As you know that transition elements, they have 9 valence orbitals. So they should have 18 electrons in total. But in case of unsaturated compounds, it does not have, these compounds do not have 18 electrons in their valence shell. So they are called as unsaturated metal center. Here unsaturated means not the double bond, but here unsaturation means the less than 18 electrons in the valence shell of metal centers. And the second requirement for non-polar reagent is oxidative addition occurs via concerted or three-center mechanism. So we will discuss about the mechanism of these reagents in the series of these oxidative addition reactions. So first we can remember some things, some points that oxidative addition reactions occur through concerted or three-center mechanism. That will be explained or discussed later in the different lectures. Now, we can see about the polar reagents. So, if we see the polar reagents, so oxidative addition of polar reagents, it occur via SN2 mechanism, it can occur via radical mechanism, or it can occur via ionic mechanism. So we can think that there are four types of mechanism of oxidative addition reactions. One is concerted mechanism. Concerted mechanism or three-center mechanism that non-polar reagents can undergo. And the other three are SN2, radical and ionic mechanism through which oxidative addition of polar reagents will take place. Now, I have told that non-polar reagent requires a site of coordination unsaturation. So, I can explain with the help of example. This is the example. In this example, you can see that this metal center is IR1. And if we count the total number of electrons in this metal center, it is equals to 16. 8 electrons of IR1 and 2 from this phenylphosphine ligand, triphenylphosphine ligand, 2 from this chlorine and 2 from this oxygen. This is Waska compound. And this compound is coordinatively unsaturated. And this this unsaturated compound can easily add this H2 because it has possibility of addition of this hydrogen because it has a vacant site. Because it is 16 electron system, so it has a vacant site so that it can attain 18 electron count. So it can easily undergo oxidative addition reaction, and then its oxidation state increases by 2, its electron count increases by 2, and its coordination number increases by 2, as in this reactant it is having 2 plus 1 plus 1, 4 coordination number, while in this case it is having 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is having 6 coordination number. So this is the first requirement for the nonpolar reagent, that the metal center should be coordinatively unsaturated. It should have less than 18 electrons in its valence shell. If any central metal system has saturated kind of its saturation coordination, then you can see that in this case there is 18 electron in this complex. It is having 18 electron, so it can't undergo oxidative addition reaction with this non-polar reagent. But it can undergo oxidative addition reaction with this polar type of molecule. So, for a non-polar reagent to be added to this metal complex, it should be coordinatively unsaturated. In this case, it is coordinatively saturated because it is having 18 electron. So, it can add this kind of reagent, that is polar reagent. So, this reaction can occur via polar reagent, not by non-polar reagent. So, non-polar reagent requires a coordinatively unsaturated metal center. So this is the characteristic of an oxidative addition reaction for non-polar reagent. Now these are the different kinds of non-polar and polar reagents which can add it to the metal center for oxidative addition reactions. So you can take a snapshot or a screenshot of this classification of nonpolar and polar reagents. You can find that H2 may be a nonpolar reagent. There may be the addition of H2. There may be the addition of SiH bond. There may be the addition of CH bond. There may be the addition of CC bond. It is also nonpolar kind. And there may be addition of multiple bond species. So it is these reagents, they are nonpolar type of reagents. We can see, we can call them class A reagents. And these are the polar reagents. Polar reagents may be alkyl halides, may be organic halides. We can say these may be organic halides, which can undergo SN2 mechanism or radical mechanism. Then addition of hydrogen halides may be there. These are also polar reagents. And these the oxidative addition reactions occur through ionic mechanism. And this can occur through mononuclear as well as bimolecular oxidative addition reaction. And here in case of nonpolar reagents also, the addition can take place through binuclear or mononuclear mechanism. And the other reagent in polar cases may be HgCl2. So this is the classification of different types of polar and nonpolar reagents which can be used in oxidative addition reactions. This is the oxidative addition with 2-electron mechanism. Through 2-electron mechanism, 2-electron oxidative addition reactions, you can see there may be the polar type of reagents, there may be the non-polar type of reagent, but it is occurring through 2-electron oxidative addition. So you can see this is IR complex and this is IR1. It can add MEX type molecule. This is polar molecule. It can add R3SiH molecule. It is a non-polar kind of oxidative addition. This is HgCl2. This is non-polar molecule. You can see that the oxidation state of this IR is increasing by 2. Its coordination number is increasing by 2. Here its coordination number is 4. And in these products, the coordination number is 6. And the electron count is also increasing, and you can see that O2 is the nonpolar molecule, H2 is the nonpolar molecule, and this is the multibonded molecule. So these are the different examples of 2-electron oxidative addition reactions whose mechanism we will discuss in the next different lectures. So you can note down the different kind of 2-electron oxidative reactions, because now you know about the different kind of reagents. There are two kind of reagents.
reagent class A and class B. One are non-polar and other are polar. They may occur, the addition may occur either through this two electron oxidative addition reaction or through one electron oxidative addition reaction.
Now, this is the example of one electron oxidative addition. So, this one electron oxidative addition reaction is it takes place through homolytic hydrogen activation. So, we can see this is in a species, it is CO2 species in which this hydrogen, this is non-polar addition and this is polar addition. I have already discussed that this one electron transfer, it can takes place through polar reagents or non-polar reagents. So, you can see that there is addition of one hydrogen to the one center. So, this is binuclear type oxidative addition reaction in which one electron addition will take place, and this is through polar reagent and this is through non-polar reagent. So, from this polar reagent, R is going to this cobalt center and X is showing addition reaction with this cobalt center. So, this is one electron oxidative addition reaction. So, in this way, we can conclude the types of reagents for oxidative addition reactions. There are two types of oxidative addition reagents, non-polar and polar reagents. The non-polar reagents, they generally requires the unsaturated centers. You have already seen. So that the coordination number, the oxidation state, the electron count increases by 2. And this non-polar reagent, they oxidatively add through concerted mechanism. While class B reagents, which are polar reagents, oxidative addition reactions occur via three mechanisms: SN2 mechanism, radical mechanism, and ionic mechanism. And you can see that the addition through non-polar or polar reagent may take place through two electron on one electron mechanism, either by any two of mechanism. So I think now you can understand oxidative addition reaction. You can understand about the types of oxidative addition reaction. And by hearing this lecture, you can understand the types of reagents which are involving in the oxidative addition reactions. So, thank you very much.